Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Fairfax Scene. I'm your host, Rachel Roth. We've got a very special edition in store for you. We have digitally enhanced the 1924 film, The Road to Happiness, which was produced by the Ford Motor Corporation. In it, you'll see such familiar landmarks as Old Town Hall, which is right behind me, the old Fairfax County Courthouse, and Fairfax Station. You'll also get an idea of what this landscape was like when it was dominated by dairy farms. In the early 1980s, historic Fairfax City, Inc. secured a copy of this film to present to the public. Former Mayor George Hamill provides an introduction that explains a little bit more about the film. But before we get to that, we wanted to show you some of the techniques we used to enhance this film. The videotaped copy we were working with had deteriorated over time. One of the first things we had to do was address a tracking problem that caused distortion along the bottom of the screen. To eliminate this distortion, we had to resize and recenter the footage, not only for the 1924 film, but also for the 1985 video introduction. Though the film was shot in black and white, the degenerative state of the videotape caused some colored pixels to appear. We applied a black and white filter to remove these unintended impurities. Next, we evened out the brightness that varied widely from shot to shot in the original film. In many cases, we had to select certain areas within a single shot to independently balance the contrast within the image to provide the best detail. We also removed stray reel markers that were present in the 1985 presentation. This involved removing the frames that contained the countdown. But because the accompanying audio track was fixed, we then needed to add back the same number of frames. Fortunately for us, each reel began with a slate, so it was relatively easy to duplicate the number of needed frames. To enhance the 1985 introduction, we added some footage from the film. We also added some then and now shots of some of the local landmarks. Now that you've seen what we've done to enhance this film, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
The Road to Happiness. The silent movie you're about to see, made in 1924 by the Ford Motor Company, was filmed in several areas of Fairfax County. In the movie, however, the name of the county was changed to Clay County to avoid offending the local populace. The purpose of the movie was to promote improved roads and was shown throughout the entire United States. Due to the old explosive type of film used and the type of storage facilities available, large segments of the film did not survive. Fortunately, though, the storyline of the movie is readily understood from the 23 minutes of film that has been preserved. This 1985 presentation of The Road to Happiness has been prepared under the auspices of Historic Fairfax City, Incorporated, a nonprofit corporation chartered by the government of the City of Fairfax in 1982 for the purpose of preserving and managing historic properties in the City of Fairfax. Knowledge of the existence of this 1924 movie, The Road to Happiness, surfaced in the early 1960s when one of the people responsible for having saved Sully Plantation, Robert E. Eddie Wagstaff, recalled having seen the film in the 1920s and encouraged the then National Bank of Fairfax to purchase a copy of it from the National Archives. The movie was shown many times over the ensuing years until it simply wore out. In 1983, the George Mason Bank graciously responded to the request of Historic Fairfax City and secured for us a replacement copy of this film, which depicts such a meaningful segment of our heritage. The film has one paid actor who portrayed the son of the farmer. All other members of the cast were local citizens of the county who volunteered their services. We have been able to identify these principals. Frank and Annie Matthews, they portray the farm couple. Dr. Charles Fenton Russell, a veteran of the Civil War, he was an eyewitness as a boy to the John Brown raid at Harper's Ferry. He practiced medicine in Fairfax County until his death at age 93 in 1931 and is buried in the Confederate Veterans Plot of the Fairfax Cemetery. Louise Rinker, now Mrs. Holden Harrison, the teacher. She was at age 18 in her first year with Fairfax County Schools. Mrs. Harrison was principal at the Navy Elementary School for 14 years before her retirement in 1969. Other local members of the cast include the Superintendent of Schools, Milton Delaney Hall, and Sheriff James R. Allison. These gentlemen acted as members of the Board of Supervisors because the day their meeting was filmed, a big snowstorm had made the roads impassable. Believe it or not, the President of the United States, Calvin Coolidge. Identified also, for posterity's sake, are the Matthews dog Tip and their horse Queen. The principal locations where the film was shot are Thompson Road, just northwest of its intersection with West Ox Road at the Navy Elementary School. The Matthews Farm was on Thompson Road also. The old Navy Elementary School, currently used as a residence and situated at 3510 West Ox Road. The Fairfax County Courthouse. The railroad depot at Fairfax Station, which was dismantled several years ago and is to be reconstructed in the very near future, just up the hill from its original location. Old Town Hall. Joseph E. Willard built Old Town Hall and in 1902 put it into a trusteeship for the town to use as a social center. His portrait occupies an honored place in Old Town Hall. Mr. Willard served as Lieutenant Governor of Virginia and as Ambassador to Spain. Historic Fairfax City looks after Old Town Hall now, and in cooperation with the City of Fairfax, will rehabilitate the building over the next few years. The Road to Happiness, having been a part of the silent movie era, was usually viewed while a piano provided appropriate background music. Our presentation attempts to recreate the mood of the era. Return now to the 1920s and enjoy the re-release of The Road to Happiness.
Thank you.
We hope you've enjoyed our presentation of The Road to Happiness. While we were working on the project, we noticed some interesting facts. Like here at the Fairfax County Courthouse, there used to be a stack of cannonballs right here. But as time went on, some pranksters, typically on Halloween night, would roll the cannonballs down Main Street. By 1985, the cannonballs were all gone.
Did you notice anything different about the flag displayed in the schoolhouse? It only has 48 stars, as Alaska and Hawaii would not become states until 1959. In the introduction, Mr. Hamill mentions the Matthews family dog, Tip. Did you happen to catch his cameo?
And finally, we end up at the Fairfax Station Railroad Museum. As you may recall, George Hamill mentioned that it was in the process of being relocated. Well, it was dedicated here in 1987 and opened to the public shortly after that. You can come and visit from 1 to 4 p.m. on Sundays. Be sure to check their website for a schedule of events. For the Fairfax Scene, I'm Rachel Roth, and we'll see you next time.